Meet the royalty of proxy providers, Bright Data and Oxylabs. But only one can rule your projects, so which will it be? Let's find out. In terms of proxy pool size, Oxylabs takes the crown. Yet Bright Data is more generous with features. Both providers offer any proxy type you can imagine, ISP, residential, mobile, or data center, you name it. The proxies have unlimited concurrent sessions and support two authorization options. Proxy credentials or IP whitelisting. That said, let's take a closer look at residential proxies. Oxylabs has the largest residential proxy pool with over 100 million IPs, followed by Bright Data with 72 million. You'll get proxies from all countries worldwide with either option, so that's not a massive loss for Bright Data's users. And while Oxylabs only offers shared rotating residential IPs, you can easily adjust the rotation for each request or set it to 30 minutes. Bright Data, on the other hand, gives you more flexibility with shared and dedicated options, plus fully customizable rotation. Oxylabs and Bright Data are also crushing the data center IPs game. Oxylabs has over 2 million proxies, with 100,000 rotating options covering 78 countries. Bright Data is catching up with 1.6 million IPs and a pool of 20,000 rotating addresses. Despite a smaller pool size, Bright Data offers city-level filtering, while Oxylabs only matches it with dedicated proxies. For shared data center IPs, you'll have to settle for country targeting. But the good news is that the rotation for both pools is customizable, and you can buy shared IPs or get a list of dedicated proxies. It's up to you. Oxylabs has over 20 million IPs worldwide, and Bright Data gives you 7 million. Both providers also support ASN level filtering, though Oxylabs limits you to shared proxies only with up to 30-minute sticky sessions. How about Bright Data? Well, you know the drill. It's fully customizable. Bright Data confidently takes the lead with ISP proxies. There's a pool of 600,000 IPs from over 50 countries. In comparison, Oxylabs falls behind with 100,000 IPs located in the US and Europe. Due to a smaller IP pool, Oxylabs allows for country-level targeting while its competitor opts for city-level. But with either provider, you get shared and dedicated proxies. Of course, we must give Oxylabs and Bright Data props for their novel technologies. Bright Data's and Oxylabs' web unlocker technologies are similar in nature. Both proxy networks deal with IP unblocking, use intelligent rotation, and fight CAPTCHAs. So if you're looking for an efficient web scraping solution, definitely check them out. Now, we couldn't help but test the performance ourselves, and both providers rarely failed. That said, Oxylabs proxies were faster. We tested mobile and residential proxies, as these were the most marketed products, and the success rate for both was flawless. When connected to Cloudflare's server, the requests were successful over 97% of the time, though Oxylabs' response rate was significantly faster than its competitors, especially with mobile proxies. Take a look at the graph yourself. When it comes to handling proxies, neither Oxylabs nor Bright Data has it perfect, yet Oxylabs goes for convenience over complexity, which is seen in their product's interface. You can always sign up with the links in the description and explore both proxy dashboards. But first, let me give you a quick rundown of what to expect. Oxylabs' dashboard has a straightforward approach where each product or service has its own tab. There, you can authorize access, view usage stats, and get documentation. The only places that combine them are the overview window and invoices. While this simple system has its advantages, it also has some downsides. For example, the dashboard allows you to buy only residential and rotating data center proxies immediately, but you'll have to contact sales for other subscriptions. Bright Data has a unified system for their services, which provides a better overview of your interactions with them. Still, this system can be complicated to use. For example, instead of regular tabs, they have zones that combine plans and subusers. You can create multiple zones for the same or different services and view them all on the same page. It might take a while to get the hang of it. Plus, to enable parameters like proxy rotation, you'll have to use an additional software called the Proxy Manager. And it's a headache for all proxy newbies. Of course, these proxy market giants are now aiming to cover all stages of data scraping, so both providers have their share of scraping tools. Bright Data is way ahead in terms of tool variety. SERP scraping API, web scraper IDE, or an option of buying ready-made datasets, and even an e-commerce intelligence tool. Oxylabs, on the other hand, remains humble with scraping APIs. One each for real estate, e-commerce, SERP, and other web pages that don't fall under mentioned categories. We haven't tried all of the tools ourselves, but if you'd like us to do that, let us know in the comments. If customer service matters to you, we have some good news. Both providers here will treat you well. Oxylabs has a 24/7 live chat that's always there to answer any questions you have. Whenever we tried it, we got a response within a few minutes with some solid answers. And if you buy one of the more expensive plans, you'll get a dedicated account manager who can help you out even more. This combo makes sure you get a personalized experience and someone to fall back on if your account manager is offline. The help materials are top-notch too. Oxylabs has FAQs for each product, super detailed documentation with step-by-step instructions, and webinars to teach you about web scraping and other related topics. Bright Data doesn't have a live chat, but they hold a ticket system that usually gets back to you within an hour or so. During business hours, you can contact your assigned account manager. You can also reach out on WeChat or call them if you want. We've heard mixed things about the customer service, but we haven't had any issues ourselves. The help docs are informative too. They have answers and instructions in both text and video format, and you can find FAQs, webinars, integration instructions, and video tutorials on all sorts of topics. So it's a pretty solid setup, but none of the goodies come for free. Let's be real, both are premium providers and cost quite a lot. Though still, Bright Data is more expensive, especially if you want to use its premium features. The providers charge for their services based on IP addresses, traffic, or requests. The static proxy networks are priced by IP, the rotating proxy networks use traffic, and APIs base their pricing on successful requests. Oxylabs rates align with other premium providers like GeoServe. Most of their services use a subscription-based model. You can buy access for a month or get a yearly subscription at a discount. Depending on the service, the plans start between $100 and $500. The residential proxy service is an exception. There's a pay-as-you-go alternative. Most of Bright Data's plans also allow you to pay-as-you-go, which is cool if you don't want to commit. After you get your feet wet, you can switch to monthly or yearly plans that start at $500. Though the pricing structure can be tricky. For example, their static data center proxies have limited bandwidth out of the box, and if you want city or ASN targeting for the residential addresses, pay double. The good news is that you can disable any features that you don't need to make the pricing more manageable. To sum it up, Oxylabs and Bright Data are both terrific options for mid to large businesses. Their proxy networks are huge and packed with features. Plus, you can get all sorts of proxy-based products to make web scraping a breeze. Choosing Oxylabs would give you better performance, a bigger proxy pool, and a lower price. Bright Data unlocks more customization options and access to services Oxylabs doesn't have. Either way, you can't go wrong, so look at the links in the description and try the providers for yourself. Or check out our other comparison videos if these two don't meet your expectations. And I'll see you in the next one.